welcome back to Seasons Cleaning. This is part two of a video series we are doing on how to hire a cleaner or a clean company. There was so much information, and maybe I just talked too much, that we had to break it up. So on today's episode, I am actually going to break down the actual cleaning day and what that looks like, along with questions to ask when you do a walkthrough. So you called them up and you've talked to them, and they have a few of the matches of things that are important. They gave you a ballpark estimate, which is in your budget, and you would like to meet with them because the conversation went really well and they were really informative, and you're excited because you really want to get your house clean. So you've called them up and you've set the date, and what the next step, and this might not be for all cleaners if they're an hourly cleaner or they just do it by square footage. There's a few that will not do a walkthrough. I have tried to do that. I've always regretted doing that. So we just do it. We do a walkthrough. So what we'll do is, after getting off the phone with you, we will set up a time to do a walkthrough. And generally we try to go as quick as we can, but I always make sure to ask, how soon do you need your house cleaned? Which is a good thing to know. And if you need your house cleaned yesterday, good luck. A lot of times it is hard to find them very last minute. We're usually about 2 weeks booked out, but that does not mean that we're always 2 weeks booked out. So if you are urgent, you might need to call a few, and your priority might just be only on who's available. So just keep that in mind. Give it about a 2 weeks heads up, but you've got that call and you're doing the walkthrough. The walkthrough is the best time to answer all of your questions. Now, we do really customize. So we do walk through and we'll have a list of things that we do, and then they'll like let us know if they're like, we don't need this room, could you do this? And that way we really have a feel for what the individual client wants and what they're looking for. And that also helps them understand what all we're gonna do. So they know what to expect when we come back to clean. They're aware that we're all on the same page. So going through a checklist and going through and making sure that we've walked through everything with them is a great way to prep us for a successful cleaning day down the road. So I'm gonna walk you through a cleaning day, and alongside of those, I will let you know, that's a good one to ask at the walkthrough. That's a good one to ask at the walkthrough. So let's go ahead and get started. As I was making this video, I had to think through every step from the start to the bottom, and we do this in Another One Bites the Dust anyway. It's how we come up with our systems. But we'll start with, you're driving in the car. Actually, you're not, I am. We're driving in the car to your house. A good question to ask prior or to let them know is parking. I think it's something that people just don't think about until you arrive on the day. But we usually typically have, we do, have all of our cleaning products, which is another question that we will get to. But we typically have all of our cleaning products, and it usually feels like we're moving in and out of someone's house for the day between the broom, the mop, the caddy, the towels, lunchbox, all of these things. We pack them up and we bring them in. So parking is important to us because we like to know where to park. We also want to make sure that we're not parking in front of your car and blocking anybody in, that we're not on the bad side of the street where we could get towed, or you know, just things like that. So I like to ask them, where would you like us to park? Can we park here? Just something to think about. Another question that you will want to go through on the walkthrough and the next step to arriving to their house is the entry. How are you getting into the house? Are they going to be home or are they going to be gone? And these are another questions that you would want to ask them as well, because I do get asked this a lot. Do we need to be home while you guys are cleaning? And really, honestly, I always tell people it is completely up to you. But when you're doing that call or that walkthrough with a company or a cleaner, that's a great question to ask them. There might be some that would like you home and there are some that would like you gone. So just keep that in mind. Over here with Another One Bites the Dust, we say whatever works for you. If you need to be home or you want to be home, be home. If you just like to get out of the way, do what's best for you, because at the end of the day, we're here for you. Say that they are not gonna be home and let you into their house, which is one way of entering. you might need to get a garage code or a key or any other way that they would like to maybe hide something and let you know where it's at just for that one time clean. So you do want to talk about how are we going to get into the house that day, because if someone does need to meet you, then you need to communicate a little bit on making sure that you're arriving at the same time or that they're home at the same time. And when we do it is we usually just let them give us whatever makes them comfortable. So if they would like to give us a key, or if they'd like to give us a code, or if they'd like to leave the door unlocked, or if they would like to, probably shouldn't say leave the door unlocked, but it's preferences to everybody and we have them all over. So basically whatever they are comfortable with, but that is something you wanna ask. Do we need to be home to let you in? Can we give you a key? Is a code all right? So just kind of ask that in advance so that you're prepared and not like worried about them getting into the house. Because if any cleaning company shows up to your house and they can't get in, really, they can't really clean. So that's important. We've entered into their home, and if they are there, a lot of times we take that time to catch up with our clients because you do build friendships and it's really fun to catch up and hear how a vacation was that they went on and that we knew that they were going on and how's the little ones doing. So it's fun to catch up, but then usually we get to work. So our entrance is usually our time to say hi to our client if they're home, and then we saddle up and get to work. And that is when the clock begins, and we either start the clock if we are hourly, as soon as we have all of our supplies into the house, then we start it. But you might want to ask that if someone says they're hourly, is that start right when they show up, or is it when they start their supplies? Maybe if they are hourly, ask them, you know, what do you do about lunches and breaks and things like that, because they might be charging you if they sit around and take a 30-minute break, and that might not be something that you're happy with. For us, we clock in, we clock out, we only charge when we're cleaning. This is for the pet owners. If you have pets, then you know you're already probably asking questions because these are your babies and you wanna make sure that they're comfortable with the cleaner as well and the cleaner is comfortable with your pet. So usually you wanna ask about any of them. If we have dogs, a lot of times we'll have them up for us, especially if they want to get into our stuff or they're really hyper or they need to. But we also kind of, with Another One Bites the Dust, we leave it up to the cleaner to decide. And maybe this is because the team that I have, well, they love animals. So they're like, please let us cuddle them and love them. So they don't mind, but it is something to ask. Each person's definitely gonna be different on that. If you have a dog that likes to jump up and get into stuff, it might be best that you put the dog away, which is a lot of houses. We do have them put away, especially ones that have like sharp bites or their bites barks, or they are maybe not that friendly. So you do wanna ask about your pets, your cats, things like that. As far as cleaning supplies, this is a great question to ask. You want to ask if you need to provide all of the supplies and equipment for cleaners to come into your house, or if they provide all of the cleaning and equipment. You also, if you have a preference, maybe you would like them to use your vacuum, you do wanna talk to them about all of this. At Another One Bites the Dust, we actually do it where we bring everything. Partially because I like to use what I know. I have everything I need. I've got this in my caddy. I know how everything works. I know what products I have. But it is something that you want to ask because some would be like, we would like to use your products. So do ask that. And I do have a lot of houses that ask for preference. Like, can you use our vacuum? Which I love because it's one less thing I have to carry in. Unless I don't love your vacuum, and then I might ask you if we can use ours. But for the most part, if someone has a certain product they'd like us to use, we always say, you know, as we're getting started with them, to leave it out and let us know where it goes, and we will use that product, and they purchase it, they have it, maybe they have a certain product they'd like on their floor or a certain product they'd like on their cabinets, things like that. They'll leave them out for us, and then we learn where they go, we put them away, and eventually you don't have to leave them out. We just know we use these products. That's where they are at, and that's where they go home. So that is a question to ask. And you also wanna ask too, if they use green products, if they're all natural products, if they are good for the home environment products. So we use both at Another One Bites the Dust. We typically try to use more safe products on our regular schedule clean, but I am not afraid of some harsh chemicals, and maybe down the road we will change as we experience new products that are out on the market, because I do think it's a great place to go. It's a good idea to get some of the toxic chemicals out, especially for our cleaners and us, but in your own home. So you do want to ask that, because if that's really important and you want green cleaning, you do want to ask that, and maybe that's a really important priority for you. So just think about that. Now, if someone does ask us if we'll use green products, we will do that. But we will also work with them to figure out what products are okay and what aren't okay. And we have them, we know which ones are safe, but maybe they have a few extra that they want for heavy duty, or we haven't quite found a few that knock out something like bleach knocks out. So we'll have to discuss that, but we are here for our clients, so we like to customize. So it is good to ask. And a lot of times, I would think a lot of the cleaners, this service business, we want to help take care of you and your family. So just let us know. When we go in to clean, I'm just going to break it down for me, because I think it's going to be all over the map on this one, but the actual style of cleaning is very unique to every cleaner all over. I feel like I tend to be all over the place, and I do that because I find that it is efficient. I know that sounds crazy, but just hear me out. So like when we first walk into a house, we always work top to bottom. So I might tall wand, but instead of tall wanding one bedroom, and tall wand, what I mean by that, because I think I made up my own term for that, but it's like a long broomstick with a wand or a bristle where you can go up and get all the cobwebs and dusting in high places. So you can reach in areas that you can't reach, and it can get ceilings and walls and things like that dusted. So we always work top to bottom. But what I would like to do is a lot of times I will take the tall wand and just tall wand a whole entire level. So that means if you walk over and I'm tall wanding in one room and you go down to the basement and you come back, I might be completely down the hall in another room. So the style is a little sporadic and all over the place, but I do that because it's efficient. Instead of going from one, grabbing this tall wand and then setting it down, going to another room, grabbing the tall wand before I start to clean that room, I'm knocking it all one product at a time. And then maybe I'll do all of the glass cleaning and the levels. So you'll see all of that, and I'll break it off like top, bottom, middle, out the door. Now, if someone is home, we definitely change that up a little bit, because if I see, we'll ask a lot of times, and a lot of cleaners might do this as well. If you have someone who's not willing to work with you so much, that could be hard, so just keep that in mind. But for the most part, if someone's like, oh, we're not quite ready, we're still getting ready for the morning to leave for work, can you start over here? Of course we can. But normally I have kind of a game plan. I'm like, oh, I start here, and I start here, and I start here. And my area starts to get a little bit chaotic. I got a vacuum over here and a vacuum over here. The reason I have all that chaotic stuff everywhere, but don't worry, it like cleans up really perfect. But it just is chaotic for a minute, because I'm trying to be efficient, hitting one thing at a time, and I go and kind of hit pattern after pattern after pattern until we get to the floor, out the door. So just keep in mind, everyone's style is different. They might be all over the house. They might be side by side with another cleaner. They might have two people over here. Just keep that in mind, because everybody's style is different, and you know what yours looks like when you clean. So hopefully you will get that. It's just gonna be random. I don't know how else to help you there. Here's a quick little tip too. When this is if you're cleaning your house, or anybody, this is completely off topic, but I'm still gonna give it to you because it makes sense. Like I said, I was all over the place. Well, whenever I clean, and or if I'm cleaning my house, I do save the powder bathroom for last. And the reason I save that for last is so that I can use it until the very end, because I drink a ton of water, and you should too. And what happens is you're cleaning the whole level one, level this, level that, level this. You want to see the powder bathrooms. Typically there's one by the door, or the out the front door, or out the garage door, or out the mud door. By the mudroom. So what I'll do is clean everything, and then right when I just have like maybe a little floor section left, I'll pop into the powder room and use it, and then I clean it, and then I leave. And that way, nothing is touched by us. It's completely fresh for the person who's paying for it. Here's kind of a little bit of a side note on, I don't know if you should ask or we should ask, I really don't know, so maybe I'll get your guys' opinion on this, but I have been adding this more. If someone comes to the house and is delivering a package, or someone's ringing the doorbell, or somebody is remodeling in the house, or there's just abnormal traffic in the home, it's a good idea to possibly ask what you guys, whoever's hiring the company, would like done. So usually if we see an Amazon package and we're cleaning the front door, we'll just bring it in because that makes sense. But if somebody's at the door and we don't know who it is, it's not always the best move for us to answer. So that is something that we like to talk to our houses and be like, if someone comes to the door, would you like us to answer? Or do we just hide behind the couch? Just kidding. But you know, just ask on that one. Another one is letting your clients know if, or not your clients, that's me. Okay. Letting your cleaners know if you have remodeling going on. If they're coming to clean on their regular scheduled clean and you've got remodeling, not only is it something where they might have an area they won't be able to do, but remodeling causes a ton of extra cleaning. So maybe be a little generous with them in that time. And then another thing is if you've maybe got guests that are in town while they're cleaning, or you've got a friend staying with you, give them a heads up, let them know. Or if you, for instance, are having somebody work on maybe the plumbing downstairs, give them a heads up so that they know and they're not gonna be alone. Or if you have someone showing up to the house at a specific time, you know, communication. Just kind of let them know things are gonna be a little bit off today, but we would like you to still come and clean. And here's another little tip for you. So we clean, add another one bites the dust, we clean a lot of the glass doors or in and out entry points. So that way, you know, when you're walking in and out, going outside on the patio to have a cocktail on a nice summer evening, you don't want to see a dirty door. So typically we clean them on the in and the out. We have a rule to lock them, and then if we're vacuuming around to check the lock. But just a tip for you, if you have a house cleaner coming to your house, I would advise after they come and clean to double check, because they might open doors that you've never opened or you don't normally open. And if they accidentally left it unlocked, which they shouldn't do, not only should you let them know so that they don't make that mistake again, not only on your house or but their house, but also just, you know, you just never know, and you would hate to think they cleaned that door and they left it unlocked. So just keep that in mind if it bothers you or not, but I would just tip after a cleaning company has come, whatever doors they have cleaned, just double check that they're locked. So this is a great question to ask as well. What should my house look like before you guys come to clean? This is a really good one to ask because you just, again, all cleaners are different, but you do want to find out. Now, I think my answer for this question would be to, I always say, have it as picked up as you possibly can. The more picked it up it is, the better it is for the clean. That way we're not cleaning it around, we're not scooting stuff, you've got dishes out of the sink, they're gone, so you, the more you have it picked up, the better it is for you. But we also let our clients know if you can't get to it, if you're running behind, if you're having an off week, like we do the best we can and we can work around almost anything. But if you're gonna pay for a cleaning service, pick it up so that that way you can get more bang for your buck. Another thing with what you should have before the house cleaning company, and this will be in part two, I'm gonna go over how to get the most bang for your buck. And this is basically answers this question in a very detailed way that I believe can really give you the most bang for your buck when you hire a cleaning service. And these are all the things that I would recommend doing before, if you can, or at least a few of them will make sense to you and you'll be like, oh yeah, that's a good idea. So I would definitely say that would be very helpful. I did not mention trash, and that is one to ask, but those are little questions that you'll ask. Do you guys do the trash? Would you guys hit this window? Do you guys strip sheets and make beds. So you'll want to ask all of those things, but if they do not do that and they just strictly do cleaning, then maybe those are a few things that you would want to hit, but we'll talk about those in part three. Another question that I get asked a lot is, what about tips? And so my answer for that is, I mean, yeah, it's always nice to get tips. Is it required? No, it's completely up to you. I think tips are nice if maybe you do a first time clean or if they go above and beyond. You know, something like that is a good tip. If maybe they have, like for instance, we have team members that are out cleaning, maybe you want to tip them as they're taking a special good care of your team and we're paying them hourly and you want to give them a little extra on top of that. So tips are always enjoyable, I guess. I don't know if that's the right word. Tips are always nice, but they are not necessary. A couple things that you can do if you don't want to give a tip is you could do a bonus here and there, which is nice. Say like you just want to treat them. They've been extra great taking care of your house, or you just feel like you want to just let them know thank you, or maybe even you want to just give them a bonus. If you do such a great job, point out areas that you like that they do, point out areas that you would like them maybe to help with, like, oh, you do such a great job, the bathrooms are fantastic, and like kind of strive toward that, like you just did such a great job in the bathroom, and then they'll remember, oh, they really liked it when I did a really deep clean in that bathroom. So bonuses are nice here and there, but again, not necessary. We tend to see a lot of Christmas bonuses, and that's kind of what it's turned into, is at Christmas, a lot of our houses will, that's when they give the gift, they'll give us gifts or they'll give us a little cash bonus, and it is quite a treat at Christmas time. So just if you don't want a tip or throwing money here and there, maybe you could just at Christmas give them a little extra and say Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays or whatever. You could do something around a holiday, for instance, and do it that way. And if you feel like giving them a gift, maybe it's their birthday or it's a special holiday, they are always a nice little treat. And you know, I do have a few houses that would give me gifts here and there, and it just makes you just really love them and just want to go a little extra mile. So there is that there. So maybe it's the gift that keeps on giving. And here's another really cool thing that you can do that I thought of very last minute, but I love this and my clients do this, and that is, if you have piles of donation, like say you've gone through your closets and you're getting rid of some clothes, you're getting rid of some decorations, magazines, anything like that, maybe some cleaning supplies, you could ask your team, the cleaners who come to your house, if they would like any of this stuff. Because guess what? I usually am so excited to get free stuff. There is no shame in my game. I will take it. And I love it because I probably have more free stuff in my house. My decorations have been hand-me-downs, and a lot of them have been for my cleaning clients. And it just makes me so happy, and they're just getting rid of it. And it makes me really appreciate them as well, because I know they're looking out for me just like I'm looking out for them. One thing I would also say is if you have old cleaning towels, I love it when people are like, we have new towels and we got rid of all these old ones or these ratty beach towels. We'll take those too. So you can always give your old cleaning towels to a cleaner or two. How to pay for the service is a great question to ask. Everybody is different. Some like cash when you are there, some like checks, some like you to pay online. It really is completely individual. We just recently went over and did where you can pay online, and we've got debit cards set up, we've got credit cards set up, and that has been the most efficient way, but we also will accept checks, take cash, all of that. We've actually switched from people leaving checks to really doing invoicing online, which has made it really easy because we don't have that checks flying around trying to get them where they need to be. So just keep that in mind to ask them so that you know when you show up for that day, if they need you to pay that day, that you are ready, or you just don't even need to worry about bringing your checkbook. So those are all of the questions that I could think of to ask a cleaning company and to help you hopefully get a better idea of how the process works with hiring a cleaner and certain little things that work. If you have any more questions, you can find me on Instagram under Seasons Cleanings, you can find me on Facebook Seasons Cleanings, and you can find us on our YouTube channel Seasons Cleanings, which we will be posting this video, or you're watching it from YouTube now. And I will be able to answer them. And I'm sure there are some that I haven't thought of, but I tried super hard to think of everything and walk through the whole process with you. So hopefully this answers your questions and you are now excited to go out and hire a cleaning company for yourself. And if you stick around, we are going to shortly after this have a video on how to get the most bang for your buck. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time on Seasons Cleanings. It's better for me. Bad for editing. Now we can flip it. How are we doing on time? I feel like I definitely... Just on that part? Oh boy. All right. I guess we don't clock out when we go to the restroom. One, you want to talk to them about your pet. Is your pet friendly? Are they kind? Are they, I just called a pet kind. I don't even know if that's a personality trait of a pet. That's a really kind cat. All right, sorry, I got distracted. Even bring that, I might even do that a different day. That way I can switch up my outfit. That's lame. All right, that's it. I can outro it.